Hi beautiful souls, welcome back to my channel. In case this is your first visit here, my name is Nadine and today I want to present a new series of short yoga flows that I've created. It's the Zodiac Star Sign Yoga. So every month we're gonna have another short yoga flow. And yeah, every star sign is associated with another part of the body and also with another element and with another planet. And as you know, every zodiac has like positive and negative traits. So out of all that information, I've created a short yoga flows. And today we're gonna start with the Capricorn flow. And this flow includes a couple of heart opening poses because sometimes Capricorns don't find it really easy to open up emotionally. And then we're gonna have some grounding poses as the element of that star sign is the earth. And then also we're gonna have one balancing pose to balance the first chakra, which is associated with that zodiac. So yeah, with that said, see you in the mat and let's go. Let's start our practice today in mountain pose. Come to the front of your mat, roll your shoulder blades back and down, palms are facing forward, and all 10 toes are grounded into the floor. Then inhale, bring the arms up to the sky, and exhale, hands to heart center. Now gently close your eyes and give yourself a moment to settle in. Start to be aware of your breath and start to breathe slowly and deeply. Next inhale, bring the arms up. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, halfway up. Exhale, right leg steps behind and come on up into crescent lunge. From here we want to do some dynamic cactus arms. So next exhale, bring the arms down and inhale, back up. Two more times like this. Now hands back to the floor, step back into a plank, knees, chin and chest to the floor and slide into your small cobra. Three times dynamic. Then tuck your toes under and come into your first downward facing dog. If you want, walk a little bit on the spot, stretch out those hamstrings, or find stillness in this pose. From here, step your right foot between your hands and come on up into your crescent lunge on the other side. On that side too, we want to do some dynamic cactus arms. So with your next exhale, bring the arms down and inhale, arms go up. Two more times like this. Now hands back to the floor, step back into a plank, knees, chin and chest to the floor and slide into your small cobra. Three times dynamic. Tuck your toes under and come back into your downward facing dog. And this time if you want, come on up on your tippy toes or just do what feels good for you. Now right foot steps forward and come on up into your crescent lunge again. Then interlock your fingers behind your back and come into your light back bend. Open your heart, open your chest. Gaze is going up to the sky. Come back to crescent lunge pose and stay here for one deep breath. And then shift over into your warrior two pose. Shoulders away from the ear, hips are parallel to the ground and look over your right middle finger.
Now slide your left arm down your left leg and come into your reverse warrior. Back to warrior two. And then from here, shift all your weight onto your right leg and come into your half moon pose. For more balance, set your gaze onto a fixed point on the floor. When you're ready, bring your left hand back to the floor and step back into plank pose. Let's flow through our vinyasa. Chaturanga, upward facing dog, and back to downward facing dog. Give yourself a moment to settle in and come back to your breathing and come back to the very present moment. Then take a big step forward with your left leg and come back up to crescent lunge. Then interlock your fingers behind your back and come into your light back bend. Open your heart, let it shine, let all this positive new energy inside. Then bring the arms up again to crescent lunge and then from here flip on over into your warrior two. Very nice and strong posture we are having here. Roll the shoulder blades back and down, and your gaze is following your left fingertips. And then slide your right arm down your right leg and come into your reverse warrior on the other side. Okay, then come back up into your warrior two pose. And then from here, shift all your weight onto your left leg and come into your half moon pose. Find stability throughout your body and keep continue with your breathing. Okay, beautiful. Then bring your right hand back to the floor and step back into plank pose. And let's flow through our vinyasa once again. Chaturanga, upward facing dog, and then back to downward facing dog. If you want, you can walk a little bit on the spot if that feels comfortable for you, or found stillness in this position. Then look towards your hands and take two big steps to the front of your mat and come down into your yogi squat. Bring the hands in front of your heart together and your elbows are pushing from inside towards your legs to open up a little bit more. Now slowly sit down onto your mat and place your hands behind your knees. Let's do a couple of rounds seated cat-cow. Inhale, come on up, and then exhale, round your spine. Two more times like this. From here, place your hands behind you. And then inhale and come on up into your reverse tabletop position. Stay here for a short moment and then sit back down onto your mat. And let's do the same two more times again. Slowly roll yourself down onto the ground and hug your knees in. And then let's do some small circles over the lower back, a couple of times in one direction. And whenever you're ready, just switch the direction. Okay, super. Then bring your feet back down onto the ground and then lift your hips up and away from the floor and interlock your fingers under your pelvis. And now shimmy your shoulder blades a little bit more together and also make sure that your ankles are directly under your knees. If you want, close your eyes for a moment and really embrace that beautiful heart-opening posture. Very nice. Then unlock your fingers and bring your hips back down onto the ground and give yourself a big hug. Okay, place both of your feet back onto the ground. Stretch your right leg out and open the left arm to the side. And with your right hand, grab your left knee and help it drop it down to the right side. Your gaze is going over to the left. That's a beautiful posture to neutralize your spine. Now slowly come back to center and let's do the reclined spinal twist on the other side. It's totally not important that your knee is touching the ground. It's more important that your shoulder stays down on the ground. Then one more time, come back to center. And then stretch both of your legs out. Place your arms sideways your body. Palms are facing up. And then gently close your eyes. And we are in Shavasana, our final relaxation pose. Begin to be aware of your breath and start to breathe slowly and deeply. And with each breath, allow yourself to become more deeply relaxed. Start to feel how your body is melting down into the ground and feel the connection between you and Mother Earth. And then silently repeat the mantra, I feel grounded. I feel grounded. And then slowly start to waken up your body again. If you want, circle your wrists a couple of times and also your ankles. And whenever you're ready, roll over to your favorite side and let's stay here for a short moment. From here, slowly come back up into your cross-legged position. And then let's do one more deep inhale. Raise the arms up to the sky. And exhale, bring the hands to the heart center. And I say namaste and thank you that you was practicing with me today.